Hello everyone, Scott Mann here. Yeah, just wanted to send a little clip along about something that I did a couple of weeks ago. And it was one of the coolest things I've done in a while. I was jonesing for some excitement after double knee replacement, and when you have some time thinking about things, you come up with some wild ideas. Well, I have this Kawasaki jet ski wave runner thing that I bought 2 winters ago to serve as a rescue platform for my wife and son's new sport of kite boarding. And I've run this thing out on lakes, and you know, it's fun for a little while, but it's definitely boring shortly. So I had this thought of running it down the green to the confluence of Colorado, and then up the Colorado back to Moab. So this plan kind of formulated about 2 days before I actually left for the trip, and started making some calls to find out the legality of it, and to see if it was even feasible right now to run it on the green. I know people have run motorboats in that route. I used to do this thing called the Friendship Float in early spring when the river was fairly high. But everybody I've talked to about doing that said that they would do it in multiple days. So I called the park, because you do go into Canyonlands, and asked them about what the feasibility of it was. I didn't tell them it was a jet ski, I told them it was a sport boat, which has some rubber around it normally, you know, kind of like a Zodiac. And if you were to get a rock or something, the speed's just a little under Mach Schnell. It wouldn't be that catastrophic. You could float out at least. I did go on the assumption that I am fairly handy. I brought the red-green essentials, a roll of duct tape, and one of his favorite sayings that if women can't find you handsome, at least they can find you handy. And figured I could, if I did run into a rock or something, I could fashion something out of the pieces to float my way through at least to the confluence, and then I could either bum a ride downriver through Cataract or a shuttle canoes back up from the confluence for the river via jet boat. So there you have it. It was an adventure, almost 200 miles. It's 120 river miles to the confluence. We've got another 68 back up to Moab. Took me roughly a little over 8 hours to do. I left about 8 o'clock in the morning on the 4th of July. I can pretty much guarantee you that I was the only one that did this on the 4th of July. I did run into some canoe trips along the way, but all in all, it was pretty solitude, and the scenery was just spectacular. I mean, it was sensory overload at, you know, 40 plus miles an hour. Brought 20 extra gallons of fuel. My machine is a 4-stroke. So it's really quiet. It would bounce a little bit because of the fuel load I had in the back, but I figured out shortly that if I turn the steering right or left a little bit gently, I could get it to handle better, and I eventually moved my fuel load little further forward than the water, which was glass and spectacular. I did check in the Kawasaki manual on what the fuel range was before I left, and they said, oh, you could go well over 100 miles. Like I said, I've run it on the lake before, and I've run it all day, and you know, still come home with half a tank, so I really didn't know what the fuel mileage was. So I brought, it has a 16-gallon tank, I brought an extra 20, and was a little disappointed when I got down below Mineral Bottom and ran my first tank out of fuel. I didn't know how much was left in the machine when the fuel light comes on to refuel. I knew that, so I dumped 10 gallons in it and was a little concerned. So I backed off on the throttle and the RPMs a little bit and only did about 30 or so for a lot of the trip until I got to the confluence, and then I refueled again and I had 3 gallons left in one tank, and I pretty much knew I could make it back to Moab. So there you have it. I talked to everybody pretty much along the way, made sure everything was good. Most people were suffering from major bug bites and they were all covered up. But those biting flies couldn't catch me. It was a little buggy. You had to keep your mouth closed from the perpetual grin that you wanted to have the whole time. But pretty cool. Certainly would do this again. Don't know anybody. Well, I know one person that bought a Wave Runner for the exact reason I did. Hey, Max, you want to go next year? That is all. I hope you enjoy this and have a marvelous time. concern. And whatever comes our way, yeah, that will make it happen. Take the world in an open grave. Fire all of your guns at once and explode into space. And like the true nature's child, we were born to be wild. We can climb so high.
Bye. not letting up at all. He's going to drive to second. The ball is bottled out center, and here comes the throw, and what a throw. He's going to slide in head first. Here he comes. He's out.